I am Dr. Moneshwari from GBF Fertility Center, Mogappet, Chennai. And today I am going to talk about tuberculosis and infertility. So nowadays tuberculosis is widely known as chest tuberculosis or abdominal tuberculosis. But mostly we are seeing now tuberculosis affecting infertile women in is abdominal tuberculosis. And why it is coming? Initially it is coming through the lungs. And most of the time you would have contacted from your relatives or neighbor or from the workplace, and it will enter into the lungs, and the lung fights against the infection. In case if it is not succeeding in fighting, then that infection spreads through blood and nephritis to other organs. So some women come without any symptoms, while only infertility investigation will come to know she is having abdominal tuberculosis. So how it is affecting infertile couple? Infertility mainly because of the tubal problem. So tuberculosis affecting tubes and uterine lining, that is endometrium, and also adjacent structures surrounding the tubal status. So another thing, in men also it affects the vas deferens and epididymis, where the sperm is getting processed. Because of this infection, tuberculosis infection, the tubes gets blocked and then the sperm doesn't come outside. And also it affects the testes and surrounding structures. And usually they will form hydrocele or some hematoma. They would have gone to the doctor and got treated with antibiotic. Well, subsequently when we test their sperms, and they will have esospermia. So again, that is one of the main concern in infertility. For women, most of the time they will come with a tubal block, either corner block or because of the tubes are damaged and dilated, that is called hydrocephalus. So any of these findings will also suggest us tuberculosis. When we take a biopsy and send it for testing, and we will confirm the diagnosis. Once it is confirmed, we can treat them. And if it is acute granulomatous infection is there, then we can treat with anti-tubercular drugs for 6 months to 9 months. In case if it is a chronic lesion, then we can just treat the chronic effects, and we can do adhesiolysis, we can clear the block, and we can do a biopsy. If the biopsy comes as negative, then we can go ahead with the treatment. So most of the time the patients who have got affected with the tuberculosis have poor endometrial supply. So they will always have thin endometrium or no endometrium. Only those patients we have to consider if there are adhesions or Asherman disease. We have to treat them with the surrogacy only. If there is some amount of blood supply is persisting, then we can stimulate with the estrogen and treat them and make them pregnant. So tuberculosis is very important. And if at all you have any suspicion in childhood, if you had a long chronic cough or you had some chest discomfort, you got admitted in the hospital, any evidence of infection, chest infection, chronic infection, you should inform your doctor. And maybe in childhood you will not be seriously thinking of it, but when it comes to a later age, you ought to say this history and recheck whether the disease is active or not.